But they should pay it more attention. More is the key word here to when they eat. This is pivotal. He goes on to say that time-restricted eating isn't easy to follow. Put it in the comments if it's easy to follow. An effective dietary strategy that requires less mental math than counting calories. Okay, you have been asking, what is that miracle eating window and fasting window that is going to help you overcome metabolic syndrome, specifically diabetes and heart disease? I got a new study for you. So those of you that are new to my channel, I just want to say welcome. I'm Dr. Mindy, and I am on a mission to get a million people fasting this year. Studies like this fire me up. And I know we can use fasting to overcome not just diabetes, not just heart disease, but all chronic diseases. So welcome. I hope everything you need about fasting you find here on my channel. And those of you that share my videos out, so grateful for you. We're gonna do it. We're gonna do this together. And I just love being on this journey with you. Okay, another new study. So this one came out, I just got it last week, so it's October when I'm doing this video, so it just came out in September, and it is specifically on looking at that eating window. So I wanna kinda, for those of you that might be new to fasting, I wanna give you a little bit of a range here. So we have an eating window, and we have a fasting window. And so this study really looked at what the eating window should be, the timing of the eating window. So how long should your eating window be? Which leaves us deducing, how long should the fasting window be? Let me break the study down for you. It was published by the Endocrine Society, and it was a meta-analysis. So they looked at over 161 different studies to glean this information. The head of the study and the study, this meta-analysis was done out of the Salk Institute, which is a very well-respected institute when it comes to medical information. So I love that institutes like this are doing studies. And he has some great quotes that I'm going to give you here in a minute. So 161 studies. Now, ladies, only one of those studies was done on women. So a lot of men and women studies. A lot of male-only studies, only one done on women. We need better than that. Researchers, if you're listening, we need more female studies, please. But it gets us in the ballpark. So this is what we found. This is what the meta-analysis said, and they came out. And I'm going to read it to you because the quote is too good. Here's the summary quote. Eating your calories in a consistent, and consistent is key here, 8 to 10 hour eating window is a powerful strategy to prevent and manage chronic diseases such as diabetes and heart disease. Okay, let's just stop with that summary right there. How many of you have walked into your doctor's office and you have been given a diagnosis of either pre-diabetes or type 2 diabetes, or you've been told your cholesterol is too high or your blood pressure is too high, or that you're on a fast path to heart disease? How many of you have walked into your doctor's office and had them tell you, okay, one of the best things you can do is just compress your eating window into an 8 to 10 hour eating window? I'm thinking not a lot of you. If you have had your doctor say that, please put it in the comments. I wanna create a master list of fasting friendly doctors. So put it in the comments, maybe even put your doctor's name. He or she needs to be applauded. But this kind of study needs to, the doctor's gotta know this so that we can start to educate people. Here is what the lead of the study said. I love this. So people who are trying to lose weight and live a healthier lifestyle, how many of you are trying to lose weight and live a healthier lifestyle? Put it in the comments. They should pay more attention to when they eat as well. He didn't want to give up on food as well as what they eat, but they should pay it more attention. More is the key word here to when they eat. This is pivotal. He goes on to say that time-restricted eating isn't easy to follow. Put it in the comments if it's easy to follow. An effective dietary strategy that requires less mental math than counting calories. Counting calories is old school. time-restricted eating is new school. So welcome to the new way to lose weight and overcome chronic disease. He even went on to say that intermittent fasting can improve a person's sleep and quality of life as well as reduce the risk of diabetes and heart disease. Whew, those are powerful statements, and this is by the lead of this study. So here are some of the key findings. I want to go through five key findings, and then I want to show you how to put this into action. So stick with me here. So one of the key findings that he said, and this is really cool, this is nuance, you guys who have been following me for a while. He said that recent research is revealing that genes, hormones, and your metabolism rise and fall at different times during the day. So the second part is that eating at random times, just like one day you eat dinner, the next day you eat breakfast, breaking up and randomly eating, not thinking about the circadian rhythm in which you should eat, that is making you, us, more prone to disease. Stick with me. I got some ideas here on that finding. He also went on to say that if we align our daily habits with our body's internal clock, we will not only optimize health and reduce the risk of disease, but we can overcome chronic diseases like diabetes, heart disease, and liver disease. Then he goes on to say that intermittent fasting is easy. Anybody can adopt it. Put it in the comments if intermittent fasting has been easy. And that it eliminates health disparities, meaning that everybody can do it. And he said, everyone can live a healthy and fulfilling life using the principles of time-restricted eating. Okay, I'm gonna link the study in there for you guys so you have it, but I really wanna dive into how this looks in action. First, if you have heart disease, diabetes, if you're trying to overcome obesity, or you have it in your family, you currently have it, you're just given a diagnosis, very first thing I want you to do, let's compress your eating window every single day, 8 to 10 hours a day, okay? So this is not even changing your food, we're just compressing your eating window. Second step, so start there. Second step is I want you to mind your melatonin surges. So when we look at a study like this and he says that there's an internal clock and that there is hormones coming and going, for metabolic type situations or dysfunction, we need to mind melatonin. When melatonin goes up, you become more insulin resistant. So what that means to you, don't eat the first hour of the day. This might even be the cream in your coffee. You might need to get rid of that so that we don't spike your blood sugar that first hour of the day. And stop eating 2 to 3 hours before you go to bed. That is a general great guideline for metabolic health. Okay, third thing, the study talks about how consistency pays off. And this is really important, because intermittent fasting should be done as a habit. Just like you get up in the morning, you go to bed at night, you should start to train your daily habits to be in this compressed eating window. So for some of you, that might be skipping dinner. For others, you may skip breakfast. But we wanna take that 8 to 10 hours, and ideally you wanna put it right smack in the middle of the day. That might be lunch, that might be an early dinner at 4 o'clock, but that's going to be the best. So, and doing that daily, the consistency is gonna pay off. Fourth thing about putting this in action is that women, we all, remember, we've gotta do this different. And I got a whole book coming for you I'm really excited about, I'll be talking about that later. But women, we need to not fast the week before our cycle. So, that would be, when we look at findings like this, it was done, like I said, mostly on men, a little bit on women. I'm just gonna go back that women, we need to stop fasting the week before our cycle. So I've done a lot of videos on that. Now, what if you, women that don't have a cycle? Well, at least one day a week, if you don't have a cycle, women, to track your fasting and eating window, at least one day a week, what I want you to do is to step out of fasting. And the interesting thing about this is it was consistency over time, but as women, we need to do it a little different. So I've done a lot of videos on that. Go watch the video that I put called When is the Right Time for a Woman to Intermittent Fast? Go check that video out, because all the little nuance that women need to know about fasting is there. So more evidence. I know some of you might be like, well, you've already talked about this. More evidence, human evidence. The time is now for all of us to start adopting these principles. This is our way out of metabolic dysfunction. When we improve metabolic health, when we overcome diabetes, when we overcome heart disease, we become immune strong, and we change not only our life, but we stop spreading mysterious viruses, new viruses that show up, and we start to overcome the dysfunctional health situation that the world is facing right now. So if you guys want to know more about fasting around your cycle, I do have a course in my academy. Just put academy in the comments. My team will send you a link. I have a whole course called The Fasting Circle, and in there I am teaching step by step, teaching women how to use these principles and fast around your hormones, no matter where you are in your hormonal picture. So, as always, I hope this helps. If your diabetes, heart disease has been helped with fasting, put it in the comments so we can all learn from it. You are more powerful than you've been taught. You live in a flipping miracle, and studies like this just continue to prove that.